In 2011, Manitoba experienced a flood of unprecedented scope. At that time, the Lake St. Martin area suffered extreme damage due to the rising waters that inundated the community. This video will examine the root causes of this flooding, and it will show how the construction of the Lake Manitoba and Lake St. Martin outlet channels will be used in the hope of stopping a similar event from happening in the future. It will also examine how the provincial government is committed to strengthening Lake Manitoba and Lake St. Martin outlet capacities to better regulate water levels throughout the region. Due to Manitoba's relatively flat geography and topography, the province is susceptible to higher rates of river overflow and flooding. This is especially true in the southern part of the province. The Red and Assiniboine Rivers are part of a vast natural system that moves water from the Rocky Mountains, the northern United States, and the boreal forests. This massive migration of water is destined to empty out into Hudson Bay, hundreds of miles to the north. In most seasons, the rivers have adequate flow capacity to regulate water levels. But in some seasons, the system needs a little help. Since the middle of the last century, successive provincial governments have created a complex series of flood control structures to raise or lower water levels as required. The first such structure was built in 1961 on the Fairford River. Since then, the Manitoba government has created dams, diversions, and development controls throughout the province. This system maintains water levels along our lakes and rivers and has saved taxpayers hundreds of millions of dollars in flood damage payouts over the years. These structures were created to regulate the province's waterways in years of average precipitation. But in 2011, the system was tested by an unforeseen series of events. That year, Manitoba experienced a flood that was unprecedented in scope and geographic extent. Prior to the event, the province had above normal soil moisture at freeze-up, above normal snowpack, and higher than expected spring and summer precipitation. These factors resulted in catastrophic water levels upstream of Portage La Prairie, which then carried into Lake Manitoba, Lake Winnipeg, and beyond. At the best of times, Lake St. Martin is susceptible to flooding due to its low-lying geography. In 2011, with Lake Manitoba at record levels, the area was in direct line to take the brunt of the flooding coming off the lake. This resulted in the indigenous communities being forced to evacuate. The province recognized that this event could not be repeated. With the data gathered from the 2011 flood, the government convened the Flood Review Task Force. After much consultation, the panel recommended building several new outlet channels to work in tandem with the existing control structures. These new controls would help regulate water levels and would also improve flood protection of communities, residences, and farmland around Lake Manitoba. These additions to the system are designed to provide enhanced flood protection for Lake Manitoba properties from large floods. Construction on the project is scheduled to begin in 2017. In addition to the access road and the two channels, the project will also involve the construction of new control structures, bridges, and hydro lines. One outlet channel is proposed to link Watchhorn Bay on Lake Manitoba to the outlet of Birch Bay on Lake St. Martin. The second channel will link Lake St. Martin to Lake Winnipeg. When finished, the project will result in significantly greater ability to manage water levels. These new waterways will work hand in hand with the existing Fairford River water control structure and will help regulate water levels on Lake Manitoba and Lake St. Martin. Environmental studies have been undertaken for some time to support environmental licensing and to ensure the project meets all federal and provincial environmental requirements. As this work continues, the information is being shared with all stakeholders, and ongoing environmental monitoring will continue long after the channels are completed and in service. The new channels will also provide flood protection by mitigating the effects of increased inflows from throughout the system. In addition to providing flood protection around the Lake Manitoba and Lake St. Martin area, the two proposed channels will allow greater flexibility in operating the provincial water control system. The Manitoba government has been involved in significant communications and consultations with stakeholders and the public on the project, and those efforts will continue. The resulting new infrastructure is designed to protect Manitobans from flooding for years to come.